Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. How are you preparing? I have got quite a few favorable comments from y'all, and honestly, I feel flattered. Keep on commenting in this way, and I will also try my best to solve your problems. I have got quite a few questions, quite a few requests regarding email and notice writing. So here I am, and let's get to work because we don't have much time to waste. The clock is going on, ticking, tick tock, tick tock. So first with our notice, you all know that notice carries 5 marks. And how do we do it? The notice format, since it has been introduced in ICSE, has kept on changing, much to your confusion. You must have been feeling puzzled which one to really follow. I have seen in many schools, in different sections, different teachers have given a different format. So the best thing is to follow the ICSE format, what they put up in their website. The ICSE website, go for it, and then you can check it. For your help, I have put it up here. Just see, you don't need to write this notice. You are not supposed to. I just put it up only to tell what I am doing. So let's erase it. Yeah, done. Now see what we are to do first. Title. So title, suppose whichever event the notice is about, try to give it something interesting, an interesting title, like Go As You Like. I have given this title. So what is the event really? Event, inter-school fancy dress competition. You can put inter-school in front also. I would think that is better. Actually, I first wrote this and then I wrote it later, but you can write it in front also. Inter-school fancy dress competition. So for that, I have given this title, Go As You Like. It means the same, isn't it? You can dress as you wish. This is an inter-school competition. Then comes your date. When is the event to be held? Monday, 25th February 2019. Next is time. A time has to be given, a specific time as to when the event will take place. So time, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Yeah, it's an inter-school event, so it will take time. Place or the venue where it is going to be hosted. School auditorium, St. John's School. So they are the host, St. John's. They are hosting the fancy dress competition, and that is why it will be in their school auditorium. And remember one thing, the small place will come first, like the auditorium. Small place in comparison to the school. So the name of the school is, the school is bigger, so the name of the school will come later. First the auditorium and then the name of the school. So school auditorium, St. John's School. So these are the points, and you will in the end write for whom it is. Who are the people to take part in this event? Like I have written for whom? Students of classes 8, 9 and 10. So what is this notice telling them? The notice is telling the students of class 8, 9 and 10 that if they wish to participate in the event, they should submit their names to their respective class teachers or maybe the cultural secretary within such and such time. Suppose the event is on 25th February, it could be 10th February. So that makes your notice. And what is the marks division? Let's see. For your title, 1 marks. 1 marks for the event. And for the date, half marks. Time, half marks. Place, for the small place half and big place half, that means 1. And for the ending, for whom, it is 1 marks. So that makes your 5. So I think it is very easy and you can score 5 out of 5. I don't think there is any problem in it. And there is another format also. None of them are mandatory. You can try either of them. There are 2 formats given. I thought this one is easy, so I put this up. If you want the other one, you can always go and check it. And I will give you some catchy headings or headlines for some other competitions if you get. For example, for music, suppose it's a music competition. So in your title you can write "Sing Your Way," simple, and it looks nice also, quite soothing to the ears. Sing Your Way. And then you have dance on your toes. Drawing, splash color to your thoughts. And sorry for the noise I was making. I think it was very irritating, but please excuse. And blood donation, donate to save. Yeah, donate to save a life. You give blood, you donate blood, and you save a life. You can, if you are a creative person, you can bring out some more. But remember, the title, in that title, don't go and write debate competition. No, that is the event. Title should be something interesting. Regarding debate, you can say war of words, war with words, or war of words. So I think you don't have any problems in your notice. Now for the email, which is easier. Just do it. So for your email, the email and notice, you must have noticed they are related about the same event. So since we were talking about the notice, in the notice we were talking about the fancy dress competition, let the email be so. So principal Calcutta Boys School at gmail.com. So this is a neighboring school. You can keep on changing the name of the school. This is a neighboring school and you are inviting them to come and participate. So this letter, this email is only a type of formal letter only. There is nothing to be worried about it. Only thing is that you'll have to put the email ID of that principal, the principal of that school to which you are, to whom you are sending, or whichever school you are sending your email to invite them. So principal and the name can change, keep on changing. Calcutta Boys School, or you can join them. So principal Calcutta Boys School at gmail.com, and then you write the event, inter-school fancy dress competition. Then is your greeting, dear sir, and in the first line you will try to tell what you are really hosting, the event. So these carry 1 1, dear sir carries 1, and after that your opening sentence it will carry 1, and half 1, and your opening sentence also matters, and your body is of 2 marks, and then again the salutation like in a formal letter, yours thanking you, yours faithfully, then your full name. Suppose your name is Ashish Taneja, so Ashish Taneja, and your designation, mane what you are, maybe the cultural secretary, you are the cultural secretary of your school. So all these will carry 1 marks. The body will carry 2, body of the letter. So that amounts to 3. And your opening sentence carries 1 mark. So that amounts to 4. And these will carry half marks. If I am not mistaken, I can check it. Anyway, I think you all can check it and find it, but you will, just like any formal letter, you are telling them the event, and in the body you will tell in details which are the classes, and in the third or the ending portion you will tell that you are inviting them, so they should send their best team to participate in the event. So in the body only you will make clear when, where, and the date, time, the venue, everything in that. So it's not at all difficult. It's just a type of formal letter, but you are sending it as an email, so that is why it needs an email ID. So you don't need to go for those formal address, this, no, nothing like that. But otherwise it's a letter only. So I have been receiving quite a few requests, but I don't know why you always so worried. And especially email is nothing to be worried. Notice you could have been worried, I don't know, because they kept on changing much to your confusion. Like when I teach in CBSE, they have retained one format for I think decades. They haven't changed, but in ICSE, due to the change, all this has taken place. Anyway, forget all about it. You have got the format, and there is another format, but this is an easy one. If you want to go for that format, you can go into their website and you will find it. Okay, so let's hope that you do well and don't lose any marks, and 10 out of 10, I hope so. So I take your leave. I'll come back to you soon with your requests of giving you some assignments in grammar. Quite a few of them have asked that I should give you all some assignments in grammar. So how do I give? Do I dictate it and you all will take it down? Maybe. I'll think on it. So prepare yourself well and best of luck again.